afternoon and welcome once again to my dad's garage. Still not in our place yet, but the next one in my little mini unboxing series here from Barty RC Stuff is a big one. The last one's gonna be a small one, but an exciting one. Before we get to that, this is gonna be bigger. I'm not sure, I gotta move the camera so that we can actually see. It's a big box.
Can you see me? Can you hear me? For real, so we can open it now. Oh, this is Edge 540. There's a lot of plane in here. Ooh, there's wing bags. These aren't wing bags. These are the landing gear cowls, or landing gear wheel pants. Ooh, this is shiny. All right, so this is painted fiberglass. That is not plastic, and that is also not wood. So that's nice. That looks shiny. I like it. Okay, here we go. Oh, there's a little spacer piece in here. That's cool. All right, so there it comes. Wow, holy mackerel. So this guy should pop off just like that. Oh, how slick. This is molded plastic. Molded plastic canopy, cockpit. We got a carbon fiber joiner here. That's gonna be a through hole for the wing joiner. We got magnets and a latch and a nice metal label plate that I can't read because it's all in foreign languages, which are beautiful, but I can't read them, so.
So the above angle was nice for the reveal, but now we gotta get into it. Here's a vertical. Look how shiny. All right, so there's that lovely label plate that I'm not sure what it says, but it's cool. That's metal. I like it. Okay, we got another sort of avionics tunnel here for servo wires to run down. And down here, I'm assuming this is a battery tray. There's a ton of laser cut wood. All of this is laser cut. This is awesome. And firewall up there. That is a good beefy, that is thick too. I like it. It's a good firewall. A lot of good structure up there. I like it. Yeah, so we got a through hole for the main wing to join. This is probably gonna be the anti-torque pin. And then one of these might be where, maybe we'll have a thumb screw to hold the wings on like on the other guys. But, this was kind of cool. So what this is, obviously we removed this when we built it, but they left it in here. You could have just left this out because obviously this gets cut away when they manufacture it, but they left it in here so that in shipping, this doesn't crush or get twisted or bent or anything. So I like that, little piece. Good on you guys. Let's come around the side. Looks like, okay, so we're gonna be attaching servos. We're gonna be mounting servos in here. So we've got the servo leads already run back for the elevator and the rudder. So this one's a little bit more, just a tad bit more assembly required than the Bighorn and the Challenger, but this is also a lot more airplane. This is a lot more airplane than I have had. Looks like we've got the wing fences here, or is that just one? No, there's two. So there's two wing fences in there, and I don't know what those things are. I'll get into that later. I'm gonna leave those in the bag. There is the vertical, rather the rudder. The vertical's attached, and the horizontal and elevator are in there as well. I like it. This is one of the exciting parts here. We've got actual wing bags now. This is getting serious.
So these aren't just plastic baggies taped down in here. These are like, honest to goodness, you know, bubble wrap style Velcro wing bags. So this, yeah, man. So we got both wings in here. All right. That looks nice. So we've got, oh, there's a string. I'm gonna guess that string is for pulling the servo wire. And we got honest to goodness hinges. This is not CA hinged. So we got plastic metal pinned hinges. Nice covering. All right, we got a good contrast. Bottom and top, I think. Those are big ailerons. The best thing I like about this is if you want to travel with this thing or just store it away, that is going to prevent a lot of hangar rash. That was going to keep your wings nice and safe. And it's even got a handle. How about that? I like it. All right, let's put these wings away. Put the rest of the airplane. Oh, I forgot. Over here, we have landing gear and other sundry hardware.
We got some Velcro straps. We got tail wheel. And some more Velcro control horns. Okay, good. Those are some nice control horns. Oh, those are some gnarly. Those are servo arms. Those are some gnarly servo arms. It looks like, yeah, and then wheels. Wheels right there. And then down in the bottom, we have landing gear, main landing gear strut.
So there's a lot more airplane there. This is the biggest non-foam airplane I think I have ever had in my possession. So thank you, first of all, Buddy RC, Sunny Sky, OMP, for sending this thing out for me to check out and review. They did send it to me, so take that with a grain of salt. But I've got free rein to say what I think about it. And so far, I like what I see. I'm real excited to get it put together and really try it out. It does look like it's going to be more of a build. It's more of an ARF than a plug and play or bind. It's certainly not a bind and fly. The other ones are receiver ready. The Bighorn and the Challenger are drop-in receiver ready. I will need to look up and find out what the recommended servos are for this thing. I'll need four total, two ailerons, elevator and rudder, and also recommended motor, because it's not, this is more of an ARF setup. So there's no hardware in it. It does have all of the control horns and control rods and stuff like that. So those look really good. I'm happy about that. But so this will be fun. This will be a newer experience for me to try an ARF build. By the look of it, I should be able to run it on a FT Monster radial, possibly. So we'll see how that goes. And that's all I've got to say about it right now. Like I said, all my stuff, my radio, my batteries, all that stuff is still in storage waiting to get unpacked. So once that all comes out into our house, I will be able to get this up and running. But I definitely will be getting to the Challenger and the Bighorn first, since they are plug and play, pretty much ready to go, receiver ready. They'll definitely fly before this guy. This one will have a bit more work to do. So I'll take you along that journey and let you know how it goes. Thanks for following along. Thanks for hanging out and subscribing. And yeah, stay tuned to see this guy go together and see me get it in the air. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.